Welcome guys, welcome again to another video here, Mind Devs. I want to give you guys thank you for the support for my new subscribers. Thank you guys, but thank you for watching my videos and don't forget to share it, subscribe to the, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. The last couple of videos has been just quick videos, but don't forget to watch the how to create an e-commerce. Yeah, so this video here, I wanted to show you guys how to link if you're working on your project, if you're working on a website. Yeah, a website looks good in your computer, but it's best. So for example, yeah, let's say you have a website and you know it looks nice in your computer, but it's best if you actually can show it to the world what you can do. So they have Netlify. Netlify is one of those free, you can actually host the website there for free. So I want to show you guys how to deploy and how to connect your GitHub to your Netlify. All you got to do is create an account. So let me show you guys. All right guys, so if you haven't created an account or if you already have an account, so make sure you create an account here. I'm gonna log in. Go ahead and log in real fast. I'm gonna go ahead and log in. Well, mine's already logged in. It already knows me. It recognizes me. So, here I have my my website. My where I show my portfolio. Let me show you guys. Oh, sorry about that. So I gotta fix that. Okay, so here it is. Feel free to check it out. This is my personal portfolio, my website. So here it's called martindevs.netlify.app. You can actually check it out there too. I have some links there. You can actually go there. You can watch videos. You can download, you can download my portfolio there. We also have a coding challenge there. Feel free to check it out. Got some projects there, and that's me. Look at that. All right. So, and feel free to email me, contact me. All right. So that's my website there. So what I want to do here, I want to go ahead and create, I have in my personal computer here, I have a code here. I am going to create, I'm going to go ahead and deploy this to the GitHub, but I'm going to go ahead and create a repo name. So let me go do that. Let me call this one API testing. I'm going to pull API testing. I'm going to use that. Deploying. I'm going to call it deploying for testing. All right. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to make this one public. And I'm going to go ahead and create a repository. So I am going to go ahead and so you're just going to follow the steps here. So first thing I want to do is I'm going to go here on the terminal. Let me see here. I forget how to open it. It's been a while. Hold on. Why is it not opening? Come on, guys. Oh, there it is. Just had a little brain, my computer took a little bit. All right. So here you make sure you're in the repo. It says fetch API. So I'm going to do get init. So that way it can start doing the magic. So then over here, you're going to see some numbers here pop up. So it's creating the files. So that way I can upload it to my GitHub. So now I'm going to do git init, and then I am going to copy this here. It says get remote added to the GitHub. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. So I'm going to go ahead and click it. Fatal already exists. Oh, you know why? Because I already had it. So let me go back to the file. I'm going to fix that real fast. Let me go here on my downloads. Let me fix that real fast. Okay, cool. So I deleted because I already had it. I was testing. I was trying to do the, I was trying to figure out how to do it. All right. So let me go back to the file. Let me do it again. Let me do get init. All right. So it's going to initialize it. So see, it's going to create the files that I'm going to push to my GitHub, and I'm going to create a remote. So then, yeah, so it's ready to go. So then I'm going to create this one. This is going to be my first commit. I'm going to go ahead, hit commit. This one. Then I'm going to go ahead and hit push. So I'm going to go ahead and Okay. So it's going to publish the branch. So it's going to do that. Let's see if it works. So I'm going to go ahead and refresh that. It's going to take a bit. Okay, so I have it now. So it's there. So now I want to go ahead and connect that to my Netlify. So let me go ahead and go back over here. So let me go back to my site overview. Let me go back. No. Create a new one. Let me see. All right, so let me go back to sites. And I am going to deploy it. Give me a second. All right, guys. So then here, what you want to do is you want to go and import an existing project. Then you want to go ahead and do GitHub. And then, of course, it's going to ask you for authorization here. And then you want to go, because I'm doing one at a time and selecting what I wanted important to the Netlify, because I have to organize. I had a lot of projects that I was working on it, and so I'm trying to clean it up a little bit. So, all right. So here, what I want to do is I'm going to go ahead and configure that, because that's me right there. I want to go ahead and configure that, and I'm going to go here where it says it's going to ask you all of that. It might ask you differently, but it's going to hit select. It's going to hit select, and I think I called this one API testing right here. So there, see, I added that to my project. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit save. So now it's connected. So now it's connecting, and then I want to go ahead and hit save, and I hit deploy. So. Okay, so now it's connected. So now that it's connected, I should be able to see the link once it finishes. So it just takes a little bit, but that's how you do it. And so now every time you do an update on your website, so let me click on it. See, now I see the same thing. So now every time I will do an update on my local machine right here, let's say I want to do an update. I'm going to go ahead and... let me go ahead and put down my reminders and to-dos I'm going to put it for this amazing channel. I'm going to hit save, and I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to put down updating the template. I'm just going to call it template. All right. So I'm just going to call that. I'm going to go ahead, hit the little plus sign there. I'm going to go ahead and commit this. And I'm going to go ahead and push. So it's pushing that into my GitHub. So now, it takes a little bit. I noticed that. Let me go back to the here. Now let me go back to says deploys. So let me see, updating the templates. See how this one it did? Let me see. Still running right now, so it's still doing the update right now. Oh, give me 1 second. Okay, so see that? So now it updated. So let's say you're working on a website, you just work in your local machine, you do a commit, and now it's connected to the Netlify. So thank you very much. You're welcome. So that's how you actually do it. Like, if that is more, if you're actually trying to do like a front end developing. So this is this is just a hard coded template. So this here, you know, shows links and things like that. Now, if you want to do full stack, stay tuned for the next for the few videos, because I'm still working on the e-commerce website. I'm still doing that, but I took a little break. So I can create these little videos for you guys. So something quick and easy. Don't forget to share it. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Again, you know, all these likes and subscribes, you know, keeps me going so I can continue making videos for you guys. Okay. So feel free to comment on the bottom of the video And stay tuned for more. And I'll see you on the next video, guys. Peace and love. All right. Stay coding and stay safe. Bye-bye.